The mysterious connection between superstition and entertainment is centuries old, dating back to the curse of Shakespeare's Scottish play, if not before. But legend has it that one of Hollywood's most famous ghost stories, Steven Spielberg's Poltergeist, is afflicted by a very deadly curse.
Poltergeist is a scary movie that I saw when I was 10 years old, and it scared the pants off. Even seeing it now at 34, it still scares me.
The spooky classic has been scaring viewers since 1982 with its chilling tale of a suburban family plagued by evil poltergeists.
They're here.
Child actress Heather O'Rourke's matter-of-fact announcement became an American pop culture catchphrase. The poltergeist curse first struck soon after the movie's release with the brutal murder of a beautiful young cast member.
Dominique Dunn was the first. She was murdered by her ex-boyfriend who strangled her. She was 21 years old.
She died on November 4th, 1982, just months after the release of the first film.
Then, some say, the poltergeist curse struck again on February 1st, 1988, shortly after shooting wrapped on the third and final poltergeist film. 12-year-old Heather O'Rourke fell victim to a mysterious illness.
She was admitted to the hospital for what was thought to be a case of the flu. It escalated very suddenly into a very life-threatening situation, and in fact, died on the operating room table.
When little Heather O'Rourke went, I think everybody said, whoa, you know, this is not supposed to happen.
Shockingly, since the original film's release, five members of the poltergeist family have died untimely deaths. In 1985, 60-year-old actor Julian Beck died of stomach cancer. And in 87, 53-year-old actor Will Sampson died of complications from a heart-lung transplant. In 2004, the director of Poltergeist 2, 59-year-old Brian Gibson, died of bone cancer. And 10 years after appearing in the first Poltergeist film, actor Richard Lawson escaped death in a freak fatal plane crash.
I heard about the curse. And then I get in a plane crash, wind up trapped in my seat, underwater for the longest time, and I survive, and there's 27 people who die and 24 people who live. And going back to Poltergeist, you know, is there some correlation?
Death seemed to follow the films, but does a curse really plague the Poltergeist trilogy? And if so, what is the underlying cause of the curse? Actress Jo Beth Williams spent many days shooting a sequence involving skeletons in a pool.
You have to understand that this sequence took probably 4 or 5 days to shoot. So I was in mud and gook all day, every day, for like 4 or 5 days, with skeletons all around me screaming. Now, in my innocence and naivete, I assumed that these were not real skeletons. I assumed that they were prop skeletons, you know, made out of plastic or rubber or something.
But the skeletons were not synthetic fakes.
I found out, as did the whole crew, that they were using real skeletons. Because it's far too expensive to make skeletons out of rubber and stuff. And I think everybody got very creeped out by the idea of that.
World-famous spirit medium James von Prague believes there can be danger in disturbing the remains of the dead.
I do believe that there are those ghosts who have not moved on, and there definitely have been case histories where you've had disturbances of graves, and the spirit doesn't like it. In Poltergeist, there was human remains, and it's very, very possible that that spirit was attached to that body. It didn't like what was happening to them.
If I were shooting a movie, I don't know that I would use real skeletons for that very reason. You don't mess around in that area.
Poltergeist 2 actor Will Sampson, who was a Native American shaman, was concerned enough about the use of human skeletons on the first film that he performed a late-night exorcism on the set.
Will Sampson did come in and do the exorcism, and he wanted to be alone, and he did it in the middle of the night. And I have to say that when everybody came in the next day to shoot, there was a feeling of relief. It's possible in a situation where you have a mass of people like you do on a crew in an environment where we're pretending that spirits are all around us, I think it's very easy for people to develop a kind of mass hysteria. But I never felt it was the curse of Poltergeist. I just felt it was, you know, what happens to people.
I do believe that people can be cursed, places can be cursed, movies can be cursed. I really liked that movie. I thought it told a good story and a good message. Let the dead rest in peace.